we know now that Donald Trump will be compelled to testify in the New York investigation of him. He might end up pleading the fifth, but he is supposed to testify. There were a few last ditch efforts to stop that from happening, and some of them did not go at all how the attorneys planned. So one was attorney Alina Habba, who was scolded by a judge just yesterday after she claimed that Donald Trump is part of a quote protected class specifically because of his Republican ideology. So here is how they got to that point. Habba said, speaking of Letitia James, she has such disdain for this person because he was president, because he is Donald Trump, and he could probably win again in 24. He has First Amendment rights. He's allowed to be a Republican. And she demanded to know if James is going to quote go after Hillary Clinton, citing claims that the former president was spied on. Because the way that courtrooms function these days is you just make vague, nonspecific allusions to whatever it is that Fox News is talking about that week. We'll return to that later on the show. But anyway, the judge, Arthur Engoron, says there's no viewpoint discrimination. I'm just saying there is none. To which Habba said, he's a protected class. Engoron said, ah, what protected class is he a member of? And Habba said, his political speech. If he was not sitting as a Republican and was not a former president who might run again, this would not be happening. So she is discriminating against him for that. Now, the judge, like everyone else, did not buy this. That's not what the protected class thing means. The judge responded with, the traditional protected classes are race, religion, etc. Donald Trump doesn't fit that model. He's not being discriminated against based on race, is he? Or religion, is he? He's not a protected class. If Ms. James has a thing against him, okay, that's not, in my understanding, unlawful discrimination. He's just a bad guy she should go after as the chief law enforcement officer of the state. Which is either, I don't have the video, so I don't know if the judge is saying he's a bad guy or she's in law enforcement, so she's going after the bad guys. I don't know if it's a bad guy or a bad guy. I don't know, Brett, what do you think?
It seems like he is putting that in the basically the voice of Letitia James in her perception of Donald Trump. In her perception, he's a bad guy. And this is like how they talk in their hypotheticals and how is specifically higher court judges and appellate judges break things down a lot. And when you get to Supreme Court level, it's always hypotheticals. But yeah, this is amazing. This is for all the cool stuff in the Bible, like the good stuff, the things that are like treat other people like you should be treated. All they learned from it is how to be a martyr. And for Donald Trump, up until January 20th of 2022 or 2021, Donald Trump was the most powerful person in the world. And his legal defense is he has no power and he's being discriminated against.
That's mean.
That he's a victim here. When he himself is in this cloud of being prosecuted for stuff, investigation, he himself, he is playing the victim from a legal perspective. And what's insane to me is the way, like, for all the stuff, like Republicans saying that they need to be a protected class of people. So much of that party's legislative and judicial agenda has been to eliminate as many protected classes as possible. Is to restrict the definition of that down to whatever it is at now and probably peel back some of those levels of hard fought protections, protected classes. Only recently has sexual orientation been acknowledged as potentially a protected class. They fought tooth and nail against it. But now the protected class that the legal defense of Donald Trump wants to build a impenetrable big wall with water around it is around former presidents of the United States.
Yeah, they like that one. They like some of the Christian stuff too. You know, if it's specifically defending them against, you know, whatever they want to do to the LGBTQ community. But yeah, you're right. And look, this is obviously nonsense. I mean, it's demonstrable nonsense. She was laughed out of court. He is going to have to testify. But the idea that like you're just going after him based on his ideology, when there you can't cite anything specific about Letitia James or the investigation that has to do with his ideology. It's financial crimes he's committed. But if that was your actual case, then look, they're constantly saying to lock up Hillary Clinton. Do they not like her based on her ideology? She's a protected Democrat. They would never accept that, not for a single second. This is nonsense.
Yeah, it's like, what part of your political ideology is at stake here? When we point out that you lied about how much your properties are worth so you can make money. Mm-hmm. Like, I know that's built into like the ethos of fiscal conservatism and people who are like, I'm just a fiscal conservative. But really, like, there's laws saying you can't lie about how much stuff is worth. Like, I just watched Inventing Anna. She's in jail for it. Like, Anna Sorokina, the one who was like the socialite who lied to everybody and said she was an heiress. And I
I'm watching it.
Yeah, she's in jail for that. Because it turned out, you know, according to the reporting that you know before watching that, there is no, she didn't have the money. This is Trump's basically lying about the money. What is frustrating is that they want, he has been treated so differently from everyone, not because he has money, but because he has the perception of having money.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. By the way, wasn't he a registered Democrat during many of the years in which he was doing these financial crimes? Can we get him for those then?
Check out the Damage Report podcast each day, wherever you get your podcasts, whether Pocket Casts or Stitcher or iTunes. You can join me as I give you the news and stories you want, with a range of co-hosts and interview guests jumping in on the fun each day. Again, that's the Damage Report, wherever you get your podcasts. And if you get them at iTunes, don't forget to rate and review. Sometimes I'll read them live on the show.